rebirth are normal Christian patterns. As hard as it is to say goodbye, God's reality is as constant as the sun and moon and stars, and I dare say the sound of the loons. His love is stronger than death. So while it may seem like something is dying here, we look not only to our hearts, but to the Lord, so that the joy of the Lord may be our strength. The parable of the Good Samaritan is really a picture of God. It's a picture of God's kindness, God being a neighbor, even to those who aren't able to respond, like that man on the thrown over the donkey. God is kind to the ungrateful, to the injured, to the wounded. God is kind to us. Never forget that. Diane, the children, and I leave a good portion of our life behind. When we move on August 9th. The craftsmanship of Diane's late father, Frank, will live on here in the pastel candle, which stared, and the Advent candle wreath. Frank was commissioned to make the ombre and credence table in the right corner. If I could only read what I've written. With a light above it, indicating what is, when it is on, the presence of the reserved sacrament of Holy Communion. Frank Baxter also made the two torches that the servers or torchbearers carry on high holy days in procession. The friendships we have made here will endure, the Lord willing, for many years. Diane and I can see ourselves possibly retiring to this beautiful place of the world, if we could afford it. The view from the rectory, you'll have to charge me with theft because I'll be taking it with me each morning looking out over Head Lake. I'm going to miss that and many other people and things about our home in the Highlands. Many memories and many joys. I mean, I know this is going on too long. We got Thursday night to get through yet. Please pray for us. Thank you for so much for your prayers and support for us these years. You might like to take the pink sheet home with you and pray that prayer that I put on there in this week's leaflet. Whenever you receive communion, we're never far away. A word of thanks, I'll say that in a minute. A word of thanks to you as a community of people learning to follow Jesus. Making disciples is worth it. Making disciples is worth it. I want to thank all those who have been involved in ministry with me over the years, and there are too many to name, so I'm not going to name them. But you know who you are. It's very much a team effort, and I'm very grateful. A final word of thanks to my wife, Diane, and our children, Nicholas, Andrew, Justin, and Clarissa, and our dog, Aiden, and in days gone by, our cat, Chester, who's buried, by the way, out in the yard, with his favorite ball. Now, he never played with a ball, but Justin wanted to bury him with his favorite ball. Anyway. One last thing you can do for me. How about a hug? If you'd rather have a handshake, I'm good with that, because I know hugging is hard for some people. Let's say this prayer together, if you could find it. It's printed in the bottom, where it says July the 4th, actually. It's printed at the bottom there. I'll just end with one little story. That is to say that, I think that God's made me more of a lover than a fighter, but I've learned in hockey that there is a fierceness in me that some people maybe have run up against, and that is that there's a certain determination to move in a certain direction, and I think it's important to be able to recognize that we all have different personalities, bring different gifts to ministry, and that I hope that you will continue to know that whatever happens with the building, that you would be built up in Christ, whatever your personality. that God wants to build you as a person, to build you up as individuals and as a community of people learning to follow Jesus. He's a great builder, and he's a great lover, and at times, he's a great fighter. Let's say this prayer together. Make me,
O Lord, victorious over every circumstance. May me be patient with every person, and may the joy of